Anthony Yard is a free agent.
Mm-hmm.
No one knew this. Tunde retweeted something along those lines, and Anthony Yard was in his nice little car. I was trying to work out what car it was. I couldn't quite work out what car it was.
Is this a
Tesla? Is this a Merc? But he basically admitted that he's a free agent, promotional free agent, and that's why he hasn't signed the deal to fight Joshua Buatsi. He wants to kind of get a deal, it looks like, signed with whoever, ideally and preferably Frank Warren. But if not, Yard's out there. He's a free agent. And if I'm Eddie or anyone else, I'm having a look right now.
It was a surprise, to say the least. He's a free agent, so he's not like left acrimoniously or anything like that. No. But it was surprising to hear, because I would just, with Anthony Yard, without even thinking, you just associate him with Frank Warren. Arsenal guy, been to games. And it's like, okay.
Yeah, I think he's only been with Frank, literally, since he's turned over.
Yeah. So you kind of don't associate him with anything else other than Frank Warren. For me, it's a strange one, because like, the opportunities are there in Saudi and in the UK, but realistically, if they're with Saudi, it's going to be with Frank already. So you're kind of like, now is kind of almost the worst time to be a free agent when there's so much stuff going on over there. And bear in mind, Yard Baturbi ever topping the bill, you're going to be on the undercard. Or Bivol Baturbi, I should say, are top of the bill. You want to be on that undercard and making a name for yourself, making a statement. Mm. So it was a strange one.
I think quite differently. I almost feel like most fighters now are betting on themselves and becoming free agents.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like we've seen it with Devin Haney, where they don't sign long-term deals with promoters anymore or broadcasters. They go, it's quite risky, because if they lose, there's a problem.
That's it.
But if you're a top fighter, you must almost just go to whoever's making the fight.
Mm.
So you're not restricting yourself to, I have to fight someone that's on top rank, or I have to fight someone that's got a match. Literally, I will go anywhere. We've seen it with Canelo. We've certainly seen it with Devin Haney, who become undisputed when he left Matchroom and DAZN to go and fight Kambosos with ESPN and Lou DiBella and Bob Arum. So I almost feel like it's actually smart to almost just risk it on yourself if you're confident, become that star, and then see what's out there.
See, I would say it is. You're right in one sense. But for someone like a Devin Haney, for someone like Canelo, established at world level,
true,
is the crucial thing. So I can get where they're coming from. Established at world level, you'd pick Devin Haney over most opponents he's in there with. You really genuinely would. You'd do the same with Canelo. With Anthony Yard, you look at Buatsi, for example, and you're like, that's a pick-em fight. That's a pick-em fight. You'd want to have the promotional company of Frank Warren and Queensbury kind of backing you up going into the Lion's Den in a way. Whereas if you go in a free agent and you're thinking, right, well, he's been with Boxer longer, he's their guy, you know, I can come in, I can do something, but if I lose, you know, where do I go? You know, it's a risk for all those guys, risk for Devin Haney, risk for Canelo, but their cash cows, their names, their stars. Anthony Yard, as much as we might like him, but we think he's good, outside the UK, you know, is he even that big a name in the UK? Realistically, like, he's up there.
He's up there, you're right. He's not a pay-per-view guy. No. He's not had a pay-per-view fight. Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of looking at that thinking, to a certain point, free agent, 100%. Well, like, Anthony, if he did free agent, I'd be saying, yeah, because he's AJ. Bigger. Or sorry, yeah, Anthony, yeah, Joshua, AJ. He's
I like bigger that Anthony, than, like, you guys are best friends. My guy, Ant. Yeah.
My guy, Anthony. Mm-hmm. I know, but he's so big that he's bigger than most networks. Mm-hmm. So he could go from Sky to TNT to DAZN. He could go wherever he wants. Anthony can't do that. Anthony Yard can't do that.
But don't you feel like, and you, by the way, you are right. I mean, he almost needs the backing of Frank, I think, to make this fight as well. But he's going to make a lot more money going to Ben Shalom and Boxer without Frank.
Oh, yeah.
Like whatever percentage he has to pay Frank, he's just going to go there and just do it himself.
I wonder with him making that public, is that kind of a way, kind of almost a subtle way to get Frank, in, you know, to push him into action, to say, like, I'm letting the world know.
Yeah, that's
I'm
basically free. Saying, whatever you've offered me and I've turned down, all of a sudden now I'm making the public know that I am free.
Mm-hmm.
And you better offer me something bigger. Because look, Frank would have offered him something more.
Oh yeah, Frank would have wanted to keep him 100%.
100%.
And that's a great way of negotiating, because you see it with people, they normally re-sign. Wait,
let's rewind that actually. Frank would want to keep him 100%. And let's just kind of put everything on the table here. We both have just said he's a star, but he's not a superstar in terms of bums on seats and pay-per-view and moving that needle. Would Frank want to keep him 100%? Like, what's the value of Yard to Frank? Frank's now doing all these big fights in Saudi, Tyson Fury's obviously the cash cow. There's others coming through as well. Like, how big a star is in that Queensbury stable, how big a star is Anthony Yod?
Oh, I think he is still a big star.
Okay.
I'll give you the count. I was at, his last fight was on the Hamda Shearer's Liam Williams show.
Yeah.
Now, Hamda Shearer's Liam Williams, that was the main event. That was what we all wanted to see. You still could not get a word in with Anthony Yard. And he was on the co-main in a 10-rounder. You still could not get a word in. He has his value.
What do you mean you couldn't get a word in? What do you mean?
As in, like, there was the queue to get to Anthony.
Oh, really?
The queue to get to Anthony, the queue to get to Tunde. It's not that he would just abandon you or anything like that. People are interested.
Yeah.
People want to speak to Anthony Yard. People want to watch him. So even if you have him as a co-main event, he is, people are like, oh, Anthony Yard's fighting on this card? All right, I'm in. I'm watching.
And another reason as well, which I was only playing devil's advocate there when I asked that question. Another reason why I think Frank has to keep him as well is because we know Frank is doing incredible things in Saudi. The domestic thing is important still.
Oh, yeah.
And you look at potentially who could be the next guy to sell out an arena domestically. It really is in that stable only Anthony Yard
100%.
When he fights Joshua Boatse.
That's it.
And is that a pay-per-view fight?
I'm going to say no.
Okay.
Not quite. I'm going to say not quite because Yard is up there, but he's not quite pay-per-view, nor is Boatse. I would say that is 100%.
I think this is the problem then. I think this is the reason it's been stalling. I know Boatse's made videos as well saying, come on, Yard, get with it. I think both guys want an incredible amount of money.
I was just going to say.
And I don't think... Ben Shalom and Boxer or Queensbury are going to have to take a hit on this.
That's good. It's almost to the point where both guys want so much. It's like, we know it's not pay-per-view.
They both want seven figures.
It has to be pay-per-view.
Yeah, it has to be to pay them what they want.
Exactly.
But it's not pay-per-view.
No.
I agree with it's not pay-per-view. I know Tunde was arguing with me the other day when he said something like, along the lines of, it's a stadium fight. I was like, it depends what stadium we're talking about.
Oh, yeah. Like, yeah, it's not. One stadium, maybe.
Yeah, it's not that, is it? It's not that. So. I do wonder what they do with this one, just because I agree. I don't think it's a pay-per-view, but I don't know this for a fact, but I'm guessing both guys want seven figures
100%.
To get in the ring with each other. The only way you get paid seven figures is if it's pay-per-view or if someone takes a hit and takes a loss on it just to make the fight.
But does either promoter want to do that? I can't envision a promoter wanting to just go and be like, right, I know I'm going to take a hit on this unless you can see real potential down the future.
TNT wouldn't do it.
No.
Sky would. I think Sky would take the hit almost just to say, we're still here. We are still, I don't think they are. I think DAZN are. I'm not just saying that as a DAZN team, but I think DAZN are the biggest, but we're still here and we're the biggest. I think they would want to take a hit to do it and put on big shows. I think they're on a nice little trajectory after the Fraser-Clark-Wardley fight,
yeah.
And they want to still do more big shows. And I think it'll be a problem for them doing it on pay-per-view, but I think if they could put this on non-pay-per-view, I think this is a win-win for Boxer.
That's a win-win for Boxer. And it's funny you said that. Sky are desperate to do their own pay-per-view because the pay-per-views they've done for a while now, I can't even think of the last, you know, in-house Boxer pay-per-view
Amikon?
I think it was Liam Williams versus Eubank 2. That was pay-per-view. Both were on pay-per-view. And that's the last one in-house they've done. The rest, they've been, you know, taken off TNT and Frank and DAZN as well. They've been saying, hell, can we come in and can we show it as well? They haven't been able to do a in-house pay-per-view of their own. They're having to go to other people and say, do you mind if we come in and, you know, offer our services, let we can show it?
And if we're brutally honest, apart from the Aziz fight for Boatse, the Boatse signing hasn't been fantastic yet.
No.
It will be if they fight Yard.
If they fight Yard, if they fight Yard, it will be. It pays off.
Who's favourite for you in that fight?
I would still favour Anthony Yard. I've always gone back and forth the whole time. I was like, well, I'm like, yeah, Boatse. But the last about year, I've looked at Boatse and I've been like, I don't know, I'm seeing a bit stagnant there. I think that Yard, if it all falls well, if all the, you know, dominoes fall into place, Yard wins.
Yard just still looks so fresh.
He does.
Like, I was watching him the other day and I was like, it's so smart the way Tunde's managed him. And Tunde's obviously looking at him, not just from a manager's perspective, but almost like a brother, maybe even a father-son relationship. I know there's not that age gap between them. Where he puts him in against a Kovalev. And then, let's be honest, he drops down to D-level. No disrespect. And then he puts him in against a Poturbiev. And then obviously Lyndon Arthur's the outlier in this, but then he drops down to D-level. So it's almost like he waits for him to heal. And then he's like, you're ready to go again.
But the thing is, even in those losses, with the exception of maybe Poturbiev, against Kovalev, he just got fatigued. He didn't take a beat.
No, man. He just got fatigued. The jab wasn't a painful jab that knocked him down. He was just shattered.
Yeah, he could have.
And that was their, both of them, that was their first experience on the big stage.
That was it.
So they both made mistakes in it. He made a mistake and Tunde made a mistake.
Against Arthur, he could have went next week.
Yeah.
So he's not taken, like, he's three losses, but he's not taken beatings. The Beterbiev fight, even then, that was competitive. He did a better job than Callum Smith.
Mm.
So he is fresh. Yard's, what, 32 years old there?
32. Boatsy's, I think the same age as around Boatsy. I think Boatsy's a bit better.
So both guys need to get a move on, really, don't they? When you think about it, they're not getting any younger.
No, but you know when we say get a move on, sometimes you can't. Sometimes the top of the tree is so good, it is what it is. And the top of the tree is Bivol and Beterbiev. And as much as I like, neither man are beating Bivol or Beterbiev.
No.
Neither man. And now all of a sudden, Benavidez looks like he's going to join the division as well. It's a top of the tree, which is good. So sometimes just make the money fighting each other.
Exactly.
You can make Chuck Callum Smith into the mix. Just make money fighting each other and you'll be okay.
Beterbiev, Bivol, the chances are one or both are going to go different ways after this.
Yeah.
So it's going to leave a little bit of a gap. You'll get a gap. So say you're Anthony Yard, you go in, you fight Boatsy, you lose. There's still a chance you can get a belt. It's not the end, it's not over.
Yeah.
It's not the end of the world. You can still do something. Dan Aziz could even do something.
And ultimately, as I speak to a lot of these boxers, and I'm speaking to Tyson Fury about this, although he lies a lot, he says belts don't mean crap, it's just the money. And he referenced it, and a lot of these boxers do reference this point, that it's just the money. And even if they don't get a belt, Yard has made some good money with Kovalev, Beterbiev, and now looks like Joshua Boatsy. And Boatsy looks like he's going to start making some good money as well. So ultimately, look, I'm a big fan of both. Mm-hmm. I know both. I wish both good luck. Hopefully it happens in the summer. But Yard right now is in a strong position. The fact that he is, as he says, a promotional free agent and can go anywhere and make the money. I wouldn't mind seeing Yard versus Callum. I do think Eddie would knock on the door. And
100%.
As much as Boatsy Yard is the one I want to see, Eddie would definitely say, two-fight deal, we give you Callum Smith first. And we'll chuck it on paper.
I think any promoter would be mad not to. In the UK,
yeah,
Anthony Yard, he's not quite there pay-per-view, but he's a massive name. And you get Tunde with him as well.
And that alone is an additional
free
benefit.
Say what you want to say about Tunde, but I don't think Yard would have as much people talking if it wasn't for Tunde.
Tunde's happy to take all the bullets and all the shots. Take all the fire. A bit like Sam Jones does with Jack Cattrall. It's a bit like that. It's but you need these managers. I love them. I think they're fantastic. And if Tunde can't train fighters, it looks like a lot of fighters don't go to him to get trained, he should become manager of a lot of fighters and become their mouthpieces.
He would. The amount of fighters who just, they don't have the gift of the gab, there's no charisma
He'll
there.
Be fantastic.
Tunde will have people, they don't say a word in an interview, but it gets 100,000 views just because of what Tunde's been saying.
Exactly. Does it happen? Yes or no? What's the yard?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
On happens. Boxer or TNT?
It's going to be on Boxer.
On Boxer. 100%. Indeed, I agree with you. G-Man in the building. Subscribe to his channel. Link is in the description. He's here for a few more videos. We're going to enjoy ourselves. And then we're going to go to the press conference on Monday and sample some of the sights of the best boxers on planet Earth. Peace.